Jones Valley area was on fire.
It was extremely difficult to drive down the road with animals all over the place.
I said, Vienna, get the dog in the car and go.
I was trying to find the cats, but the cats were gone.
Yeah, it's me and the dog's whole life right here. I wasn't going to leave it. Nobody's going to fight this fire better than me.
All the fur was burnt off. The claws were burnt off. He definitely had used up a couple of his lives.
Now, from the Weather Channel, it's Animal Storm Stories.
August 11th, 2004. The temperature in Redding, California hits 105 degrees with just 6% humidity. A real dog day of summer. Jones Valley is a pet-friendly community. Catherine Montague and her daughter Vienna share a rental home with four cats and a dog, Romy. A half mile south of the Montague home, sparks from a lawnmower ignite the dry grass. Around 1:30 p.m., a wildfire jumps to life directly across from the local volunteer fire station. Mark Romero of the California Department of Forestry and Fire Protection is alarmed by the blaze's speed.
The fire created a chaos because it did not spread in one general direction, but in literally 360 degrees at once.
Vienna brings Romy into the house and phones her mother at work. Catherine is a manager at a self-storage facility about 25 miles away.
And I told her, I said, Vienna, get the dog in the car and go.
I was trying to find the cats, but the cats were gone.
53-year-old Smith has been in a wheelchair since a mining accident 25 years ago. Glenn's dogs, Koji and Johnny, are his constant shadows, especially today with sirens blaring across the valley.
Johnny's just a bundle of nerves. I put her right in the house. She can see I'm out there. If everything's okay, she's right there at the glass door.
Koji, a 6-year-old yellow lab, tracks his owner's every move.
He's right on my heels, and he's nervous, but he's sticking right with me. And he's just real watchful of anything going on.
Safe at her relative's home, Catherine watches news of the fire on television. Suddenly, images of her rental house fill the screen.
I see the flames going up on the deck of the house. I see the door, I see everything.
Catherine's residence and all her possessions burn before her eyes.
The thing that I never conceived of happening is happening. I had never actually thought that the house would burn down.
Montague's thoughts turn to her four cats. She holds on to hope that Shaq, Coco Puff, and the two others somehow have made it to safety. Firefighters charge up the hill where the flames are jumping from one dried out tree to another. Glenn trades his garden hose for one on the fire truck.
They had a spare hose there, and I said, well, Koji, nobody's using this one. And I just locked my brakes. Don't usually use them, but I locked my brakes because I didn't know where I was going when I turned that thing on. But I hit it, and I said, shoot, we're good with this.
The fire is kept at bay. After fighting for 4 hours, Smith's home is out of danger. When Catherine Montague arrives looking for her missing cats, she spots the injured animal.
I said, Shaq, is that you? And then the girl looked at me like, wow, I can't believe, is that you, really your cat? I said, yes, yes, he's my cat. No fur, no claws, like that. And the vet said he definitely had used up a couple of his lives.
For the next 4 days, Shaq undergoes treatments for severe burns. The injured feline takes it all in stride.
That cat just, won everyone's heart here because he truly knew we were trying to help him. And he never growled at us when we put the medication on him. He never tried to pull his foot back. He just looked at us as if to say thanks.
August 2004, a wildfire has burned more than 10,000 acres and destroyed 86 homes in Redding, California. Catherine Montague has reluctantly given up finding her three missing cats.
It was getting to be dusk, and I saw a cat run in front of the headlights. And I thought, wait a minute, that looks like one of my cats.
Catherine turns off the headlights and steps out of her car. Slowly, she approaches the frightened feline.
And I grabbed her, and I was petting her, and it was just like, oh, thank God, I've got my Cocoa Puff. Oh, thank goodness.
Unfortunately, the other two cats are never found. Even after her loss, Catherine remains positive about her future in Redding. She and Vienna look forward to the day when they, along with all their pets, find a new home.
I tell my daughter, I said, I know there's a plan. I said, God always has a plan. I just don't know what it is yet.